Hello friends, today we are going to work on the practical static routing. The diagram is already implemented on the window. I have configured these two PCs by providing the IP addresses directly to them. All the three PCs were configured. Okay. Now I have created two network. One network is 192.168.1.0 and another network is 192.168.2.0. So accordingly IP address is provided, and for router default gateway is provided with the IP address 192.168.1.1 and another router for 192.168.2.1. We have connected both the routers using one serial cable. And the IP address given is 10.10.0.2 and another is 10.10.0.3. So we will directly start with configuration of our router. We'll first go to our router, router number 1, that is 0. See. The fast Ethernet. So we have to give the IP address to the fast Ethernet. Fast Ethernet IP address, that is nothing but a default gateway for all the PCs via which they will travel to the next area. So IP address for the same is 192.168.1.1. Subnet mask will be selected on the connection. Simultaneously we'll go for serial cable SE 2/0. Serial cable 2/0. IP address is, we can see here, 10.10.0.2. So 10.10.0.2. Subnet mask, the clock is available. If you see the clock is available, it is set to 64,000 on the connection. For this router, all the connection is done. We will close it. Now we will go to the next router. In this router, if you can say, if you can see, the network is 192.168.2.0. Fast Ethernet for the same IP is given 192.168.2.1. Fast Ethernet 0/0. The IP address is 192.168.2.1. Submit mask select automatically. On the connection, for the same we have to give the configuration for serial 2/0, where clock is not assigned or clock is not available. So we will first not set. IP address for the same is 10.10.0.3. Subnet mask selected. On the connection, close. If you see, all the connection link are converted to the green, that is the connection is done properly. Right now we work on static routing, how the static routing provided. When we are at one location, so static routing, what do you mean by static routing? Static routing, which defines the explicit path between two routers. It will define the explicit path between two router, which cannot be automatically updated. So this path, we have to set it manually. So manually configuring the static routing, if you see here, static routing. And this static routing take less bandwidth as compared to the dynamic routing. So static routing, in static routing it will ask you for network, mask and next hop. So network, when you are working on static routing, we have to specify this router, what is the explicit path to reach up to this destination. So it is asking for the network, so we have to provide the network of the next router. So the next router network is 192.168.2.0, 192.168.2.0. network mask, as the subnet is not provided. If subnet mask is provided, say 2.0, we have to give here subnet mask provided, for example 192.168.2.1 slash 2.2 slash 16 is given. So the subnet mask for the same of this network is 255.255.0.0, because 16, that is our main IP address, is divided into 4 OC. So each OC carries 8 bits. So 8 into 8 plus 8, 16. So 16 hops. So then subnet mask is not given here. So we will directly provide 255.255.255. 0, that is subnet mask. Next hop from this router, the next hop will be 10.10.0.3. So 10.10.0.3. We have to add this configuration. Click on add. Estimate something. I'll remove this. 192.168.2.0. 55 and 3. Next hop. Add. It get added. Go to the setting. Save the connection. Close. Now we'll come to this router. In this router, we again set it static routing manually. It is asked for network. So in this router, network is 192.168.1.0, 192.168.1.0. Ask for mask, so 255.255.255.0, and the next hop is 10.10.0.2. That is the next hop. I'll first remove this. Okay, then click on add. It get added. If you see the subnet mask I'm talking about, that is 192.168.1.0. It will take 4 aux, so it will take 24. So for 24, the subnet mask will be 255.255.255.0. If it is, if in exam it provide 192.168.1.0/16, so the IP address, the mask will be 255.255.0.0. This will be the mask for the same. We already add it. We'll have to save it. Go to the NVRAM, save the connection, close. As we have done the configuration for fast Ethernet 0/0, serial mask, as well as we configure the setting for the static routing, the IP address for all the PCs we have provided already. Now we have to check whether our packet will flow in the network using static routing. In progress, it will first fail. Then we will go for the second, it is successful. Now we will go for this PC to this PC, it's successful. When it configured once, when the process is done properly, the table for the same is generated at each and every router, which will show them the path between source to destination, which is generated at individual router. So this is how we can configure the static routing. I hope you understand it. You can add one more PC at this level, or you can add one more router and create another network, and by creating network you can configure the given practical using static routing. Thank you so much.